The last 3 years, I have noticed something about Roblox buildings. Why do developers never get the color right? Just pick the right color. I have seen so many Roblox builds in my lifetime, especially in the early days. And for some reason, 90% of the time, people like to color their builds really unrealistically, even when they're trying to be realistic. Me being a child, I just sort of brushed it off as this is just how people normally build and this is just the way Roblox is, until I saw my first ever showcase, Apartment 23 by Joseph155, where he was able to balance all of his colors perfectly. Not a single one looked out of place or wrong. Everything just worked in conjunction with each other, and it made a beautiful unified space that felt realistic and easy to look at. And ever since that day, I have never been able to look at builds the same way. The average builder likes to use really highly contrasting colors, which just makes a build look quite unsightly. Things made out of wood are particularly hard for Roblox builders. They like to make them way too vibrant and eye-straining, yellowish. It kind of looks like poo. Or too light or too dark. There seems to be no in-between. And it sucks because, believe it or not, choosing the correct colors and making them all work together is crucial to building, and getting it wrong can and will really badly reflect on your build. For those who do not know who I am, hello, my name is Holly. I am a showcase artist on Roblox. I make hyper-realistic builds, and I have been doing so for the past 6 years. Today I want to talk to you about picking out the right colors for your Roblox build and how to make colors work well together. Keep in mind that my background is of the realistic style, and so this video will not necessarily apply to other styles. However, there are definitely things that you can take in this video that are transferable to all styles of Roblox building. Roblox builders really struggle with wooden objects, like I mentioned. And to prove this point, I actually set my Discord members with a little task. I made an announcement in my events channel where I tasked everybody with building a specific piece of furniture. Here it is, right here. And I am so thankful for everybody who participated in this. I gave you only 2 days to do this, and you all surprisingly worked really fast, so well done. Here is every single entry. A lot of people submitted joke entries, and some of them are really funny. This is absolutely horrifying. It's almost like pixel art. Oh god, what happened? This one's kind of got a dumpy. This was the first entry. Love to see it. This one looks amazing until you realize that they only made this part, and then the top part is just the picture but on a decal. It's really interesting to see how differently everybody goes about making the same thing. Some people made their build exclusively in Blender, some, like me, only used Roblox Studio, and others used a little bit of both. Some just used AI. Look at this entry. This one is really interesting. They used a very dark wooden texture, and while it is quite beautiful, it doesn't actually look much like the reference in terms of the color. It's darker and more cold, whereas the original image, it's brighter. The wood is more processed, it's smoother. The advice I would give to this is to make the wood lighter. However, I know this wood texture. This is a very popular one on Roblox, and it's one that you can't actually lighten. So I would suggest using a completely different wood texture. Let's talk about this, actually. The textures that you use in your build will often affect the colors of that build. For example, here are two parts. They're exactly the same, exact same color, exact same material. However, when I add two different textures onto them, the colors are now completely different. This is the vanilla wood texture on Roblox, and if you zoom out, it makes the white turn from, well, white to almost a little bit more pinkish gray. And then with this texture, it has made the wood appear more yellow. These are still the exact same color underneath, by the way. If I change the color to, let's say, lavender, you can actually see now that one is a lot more purplish and the other is a lot more plum. Picking out the right textures is really important, because a lot of the time they can affect the color underneath them. Roblox changes the colors of your textures depending on how much white is in them. So if I added a new texture that was mainly brown, you can see that looks completely different to the other two. Even though it's still got the same hue underneath, it's affected a lot less because the original color of the texture is a lot more orange. And if you want to neutralize this orange color and get rid of it, you'll have to use the opposite color. This is color theory and is something that might be a little bit complicated for some people. However, generally speaking, if the color is on the opposite end of the wheel, this is the color that neutralizes it. So if I want to get rid of this orange, well, the opposite color of orange is cyan. And so if I add a little bit of greenish cyan into that, you can see that it starts to get rid of that orange and turn more gray. This is what I call color neutralizing. You're getting rid of that vibrance by adding in the opposite color. By the way, these two textures that you're seeing here are not vanilla Roblox textures. These are ones that I've added myself or found. And there's so many reliable places to find textures that you can use for Roblox building. The easiest way to find them in the toolbox, can you see the categories here? If you click see all and then scroll down to materials and click that, you're given so many different unique materials that you can add into your build. Some of them are quite strange. This one appears to have Rick Astley on it. If you see PBR, that's a really good sign. That means they're really detailed and they change depending on the lighting. This material you can see here is PBR. It's a flat surface, but it appears 3D because of the light. And when I move the light, you can see that different parts of it reflect that light. Anyway, let's look at more builds because I'm getting a little distracted. This player here used the OG wood texture on Roblox, and it is quite accurate to the reference as well. I would say the brown needs to be ever so slightly more rich. By rich, I mean less whitewashed. Look at these two amazing examples here. These are wonderful. Ah, look at that topology. Only years of experience can get you that topology. This one's very interesting. He went down the Skyrim route, and while it's not very true to the reference, you can clearly understand that this user had really good understanding of lighting and balance. He purposefully made the wood on this piece of furniture much darker to fit with the theme of Skyrim, so he was able to match all of these potions up. Notice how the leather around these potions is a really good complement to the wood here. The only feedback I would give to this is that the corks are a little bit too bright. They do take your focus a little bit towards them. And also the journal here, the white texture on it is a little bit too bright as well. I would lower that down. This here is a really good example of what I meant about things being too vibrant. This is a lovely build. However, using a metallic wood, as you can see here, they've added a bit of specular to it. It's turned that wood from the old dull brown that's in the reference to this very rich red, orange, almost copper-like feel. And it's really not true to the reference. And I'm not sure if that's on purpose or not. However, it does fight a lot with the other colors. I feel like it works very well in conjunction to this green. However, when you add too much white in and too much of this yellow, that's too many vibrant colors and it can be very difficult for your eye to look at. Here's a lovely build, very unique. The book textures are nice and dull and they really work well with the dull brown. Only advice I would give for this one is to make the telephone here a little bit darker because once again, it does draw your eye to it and it needs to camouflage in a little bit more. I've noticed that a lot of people have struggled with the dimensions of the build. Some people have made it a little bit too wide, like in this one here, and some people have made it a bit too narrow, like this one. This usually happens because you blocked it out first and you didn't really have many reference points for things like the width of the doors and the drawers. In my time lapse, which I will show you very soon, I'll show you how you can conflict that and make sure that your build is at the correct proportions early so that you don't have to spend lots of time later moving things around. Slightly off topic, but also still on topic, because you've used the yellow light, it's highlighted this brown and turned it green, and it's also because it's warm, it has really, really brought out the red of those books, almost violently so. It really does stand out to your eye and it's quite unpleasant to look at. If you want to use vibrant lighting, you need to use neutral low colors on your build. And if you want to use vibrant colors, you need to use neutral low lighting. They work in conjunction with each other, you see. Here's a really good example of what I mean with people that struggle with wood. I can tell from this build that they didn't use the color slider in the properties. They only used the brown color options that Roblox gives you at the top. And because of that, when they wanted to use lighter browns, they've had to choose ones that are more vibrant. You can see these are way too red compared to the reference. My number one piece of advice for you is to start utilizing the color slider in the properties. And also don't be afraid to neutralize them. Bring that slider all the way down into the white area. That means that it's more neutral and less vibrant. You'd be surprised how using neutral colors and just playing around with the hue and the brightness will actually make that wood look much more realistic than if you just play around with the vibrance. There are some absolutely beautiful builds here. I particularly like this one a lot. The colors are very accurate. I see no things that are standing out to me. This isn't on the topic of lighting, however, it is something I want to point out. One thing that I've noticed a lot of builders do is block out the shape of their build and then texture it later. And I am especially against this. A lot of this wood isn't following the correct grain. See how there's lots of stripes that are pointing vertically? These would actually in real life be pointing horizontally. And you can fix that on Roblox by rotating the part 90 degrees and continuing the shape that way. And it's something that a lot of people can overlook if they're blocking out things first and then texturing later. Here's someone that blocked out first and textured later. And as you can see in their finished build, all of the grain in this wood is moving horizontally, even though some of them, like the ones here, should be moving vertically. Same with this build here and this build here too. I want to give some additional tips for helping you out with color. First of all, the color palette that you're given on Roblox is terrible. You really should not be using it that much. I only ever use it for picking white and black. Everything else, I use the properties panel for instead. Another thing, if you're really struggling with balancing colors, consider making a color palette first. Place down something like 5 or 6 parts, pick out the colors that you want to use, place them down, make them all work together, and you've got yourself your color palette. Now then, it's time to move on to the time lapse. So I've got my reference on one monitor, so here I'm actually figuring out which textures to use. I decided to go with this long, grainy one. I felt like it matched the colors the best. This is me just laying out the foundations. What you might notice straight away is that I only am doing one half of this dress out. So I did the table legs on the right side, but I didn't do them on the left side. And that's because I haven't yet decided how wide I want this to be. I actually do the drawers first, because once I've got those drawers down and that scale figured out, I can then use it to scale the rest of the built when I copy and paste it on another side. This is why I think it's a bit of a mistake, particularly with furniture, but also with anything. When you're working with a reference, it's really difficult to eyeball the size and width of something when you're just blocking it out. And this is why with all of my showcases, I actually do all of the details at once instead of blocking out and then doing details later. So this is studio lighting, I like to call it, which is where it's just the build. And so the background is white, and also the environmental specular is off, which means that the metal does not look very metallic at all right now, and then this is something that I will change later. And so the metal will appear a lot brighter in my build than it does in the reference. However, once I put it in the actual game lighting, it's going to look completely different. So as you can see, now that I've figured out the other side of those drawers, that's when I actually decide to commit to the width that I've got, add the table legs to the bottom, and continue with the build. And keep in mind while I'm doing this, notice how I'm rotating all of the parts instead of just copying and pasting them and changing the width. I'm rotating them because I need the grain to be rotated along with it. Notice how so far I haven't really been changing any of the colors, and that's simply because the wood has enough variety in the texture, and so I don't need to add additional color variety. However, with certain builds on Roblox, there are times where you do need to add a little bit of color variety to your wood. I do it in my old showcases, back when the wood texture wasn't as realistic. Here I'm doing all the paper. I ever so slightly change the paper from white to a very light yellow, and the reason I do that is color balancing. This is a very warm build. It uses lots of warm colors, reds and browns. And so if you add a solid white color, it's actually going to appear blue. Anything that's white in this build, I actually make slightly cream. So even though it looks white, but actually it's creamish, and that's to prevent the blue from coming through that I don't want in this build. So here I am adding more assets, and you can see I added more cream to that white lantern. I actually went back and made it a little bit more cream later on because it still felt a bit cold. I'm purposefully using brownish cream books here because not only is it in the reference, it also is just a warm color. If you're curious, by the way, all of the assets that I used in this build are 3D scans of museum objects that I optimized in Blender. I made a video about it. Here's me adding some cream to that vase and then completely lowering the transparency all the way down to really give that effect of glass. I knew that glass was going to be behind this cabinet, and Roblox struggles to render glass behind glass, and so I'm using an ice texture on that, and then I'll use the glass for the cups that I'm going to put inside of the cabinet. Just stacking a few plates and some bowls, playing around with the rotation of them, and then this is the completed build. So if you look at it next to the reference, it's pretty accurate. There are some things that I've had to change simply because I didn't have the assets for them. Really notice how during that time lapse, I didn't use any vibrant colors at all. It really does not need to be that vibrant unless it's following a certain style. Most colors that you see in real life are not actually that vibrant. Anyway, I just wanted to make this because it's something that I've seen on Roblox that no one else seems to talk about. If you have any additional tips and tricks, tell me about them. I'd love to know. I love to host little build challenges here and there on my server. I want to do it more often. So if you aren't already in it and you're over 13, please consider joining the Discord server. It's a really, really nice place. And yeah, that's it from me, really. Goodbye.